Today I'm going to show you how to rebuild a Polaris PB460 pool pump. This is it right here, the Polaris PB460. These things cost anywhere $300 to $500 for a new one. You can rebuild it by just changing a couple of little parts right here and spend maybe $20, $30 to have a pump that works almost like new. So the first thing that I recommend that you do is have your workbench nice and clean, like you see here. Get your tools out. I believe you need a 5/16 nut driver, 5/16 wrench, 1/2 inch wrench, 9/16 wrench. And if you're gonna change the bearings, like I'm gonna show you how to do today, you also need some type of bearing pullers. And I have a couple pieces here of 3/4 inch pipe, which you'll see what I'm going to use those for later, and a hammer and a couple other random tools here I'll explain as I'm going along. So first off, this pump has been away from the pool for a little while, so it's kind of dry. The first step to taking it apart that I like to do is, of course, you have to disconnect it from the power, but once that's done, you can remove this nut on the back. It twists off. If you can't twist it, you can get a wrench on it, but it should just twist off and pull off. That exposes the rear shaft of the motor. Pour all your parts into a bin, keep them all in a place so you don't lose them. The next step that I typically do is I take off the front of the volute. This piece here is called the volute, and that requires a 1/2 inch wrench, and you loosen the bolts that are on it. Sometimes they're a little bit tight, but usually not really tight. I also like to loosen them in a star pattern, so going diagonally around the pump. And I also, one of the things I do, I have a workbench that's pretty tall, so I like to kind of hang the front of the pump off the workbench a little bit, make it easier to use the tools. So I'm going to break all these loose. Now this pump's been sitting for a while, so probably doesn't have a lot of water in it. So when you take apart a pump that you've just taken out of your pool, probably a lot of water is going to come leaking out. Not to worry about that. Throw your bolts in your parts bin off to the side, because you're going to need to use these again later. Yeah. As you're unscrewing it, you're going to see that the front of the volute is actually pushing outward. There's a little bit of force against it. And that's because one of the bushings in here has a spring on it, and it's springing outward. So when you pull off the front piece, it's gonna look like this. Nothing fancy, special. This is the front half of it. On here, you're gonna see there's a seal. We're gonna replace the seal. Leave it on here for now. And then this right here is your impeller. This is what spins. It sucks water in from the front and it pushes it out to the outside, which will go out the top of the volute. So we need to remove the impeller. And sometimes they come off really easily, other times they come off hard. So what I like to do is put a 1/2 inch wrench here on the back of the motor. So the little motor shaft back here. Put a 1/2 inch wrench right here, and then hold that, and then on the other side, I'm going to turn the impeller. So you come around here, you loosen this counterclockwise, and sometimes they come off really easily. One I had to really fight with, one I actually had to break it to get it off. It was totally stuck on. So holding the wrench with one hand, turn, and then it snaps loose, and it just spins off. Came apart pretty easily. This is your impeller. Look for cracks, make sure everything's all right. This is the first bushing that we're gonna replace. Pull off that, throw it here to the side, and then we'll take out my new parts over here. You can see here is my replacement part. Replacement seal. Another thing to let you know, the reason I'm doing this video is this is for a pump that was built after 2012 or 2012 and newer. Most of the videos that I saw online are for the older pumps. So when I was trying to rebuild my first one they're different than this. They have the same part number, PB460, but the internal guts on them are different. And even when I ordered replacement parts for my pump the first time around, I got the wrong parts. I got parts that just didn't fit, and I was trying to figure out why. And eventually I realized that there was two different styles or two different models of this, which both have the same part number. Very confusing. This is for the modern or the newer version, 2012 and beyond, 2012 or newer. So the first thing to do is put the new seal on this. And this is spring loaded, as you can see here. See how it squishes together, springs together. And that's to keep force pushing forward on this. Now, because things are gonna contract and shrink as temperatures change and the water is flowing through it. So this is really easy to put on. You can just slide it on here on the end of the shaft. And the shiny side of this should face outward. And that's gonna come in contact with this ceramic piece over here from the old seal. We're going to change it with the new one, but these two surfaces are going to come in contact with each other, so the shiny side should be out. We'll set that over here. We'll put that together later. Next thing we're going to do is we have to take off this front housing off of the pump in order to take that seal out of there. So I need a 9/16 wrench, and I'm going to remove these four bolts that are holding the front half of the pump together. Cracked them all loose. And I will unscrew them. If you have the older style pump, it's going to come apart a little bit differently, and they're going to have different length bolts too. So that's one of the things I noticed between the two styles. So now that that's loose, I can actually pull the motor and separate it from the pump. So be careful not to break anything in the process. Motor is kind of heavy, you can set it aside. And the next step is to remove this seal out of here. Now, you can snap this loose from the pump frame or housing or whatever this thing is called, or you can just set it face down. You can even remove it while it's still in here. I think I'm going to do that. The way to remove the old seal, pretty simple. Take a hammer and a screwdriver or a tool and punch down here. Maybe you can show inside. And push this out of here. Just tap it a little bit. It should pop out pretty easily. If you're not planning on reusing the seal, you don't have to worry too much if you break it. So it popped out. If you look, here is the old one that's come out. It's actually not in that bad a shape, considering it's old. This pump wasn't leaking. I took it apart just to rebuild it and replace the seals in it as a preventative measure. It's been running for probably, I don't know, 8 years or something on my pool every day. So I thought it'd be time to change the bearings, change the seals, and do a YouTube video. So the next thing I'm gonna do now is I need to put the new seal into this hole over here. Now they say that when you put the new one in, you shouldn't use any oil or lubricant. Now, you should just use a little bit of water and you should push it in. And some people say you shouldn't touch the surface with your hands or get it dirty. They say use a clean rag or something to push it in. So I'm going to grab a paper towel over here, put a little water on it. Get it a little bit wet inside there, a little bit of wet around the rubber here. Clean out the inside really well. And then I'm going to drop it in the hole like that. And I'm just going to press it in using my fingers. You don't want to use a hammer or a tool because a ceramic piece in here will actually break. So you have to be careful not to break it when you're putting it in. And the other thing about this is this seal. If you look at it, this outside piece should be shiny. If somebody were to take this apart and flip it around, the other side's kind of dull. So you want to, you know, I don't, probably when it comes in the package like this one did, it came properly oriented. But you want to make sure it's nice and shiny facing the front, because that's going to be in contact with the other half of this. So press that down in there, get it in there till the rubber is nice and flush. Wipe it all nice and clean. And you can kind of feel here in the back that the seal is all the way into the bar. Wipe it out. If you're just changing the seals, you can put this back together and be done. But I want to go and do the next step because a pump in the past that I had, the motor was actually squealing and I needed to change the bearings. So this one isn't, but I'm going to show today how to change the bearings anyway. Just because when I looked for YouTube videos on how to change the bearings, I couldn't find anything. So I thought it was time to do a YouTube video to show the complete rebuild process, bearings and seals. Oh, and the other seal to change is right here. This one, I'm gonna take this out and throw it away. Here's my new rubber seal. And I might as well put it on now so I don't forget later. Say to put a little bit of this pool and spa lube on it, a little bit on your finger. I'm doing this so I don't forget to do this when I'm done. I'm putting it back together. Rub that around on there, and then slide this new seal around the outside. Push it in there so it's nice and flat. Wipe my hands off, and then we'll come back to that when we put it back together. And the old seal, we can throw it in the trash with the other old parts. Now this part's gonna be a little bit more complicated. If your motor is running fine, you can skip this step, but I thought, since sometimes people do need to change the bearings, and I couldn't find any videos that showed how to do it, and after a little bit of learning, I thought that I would do my own video. So the first thing to do is let's take off this back side of the motor. Actually, we're not gonna take it off. We're gonna loosen this bolt down here a little bit. And this takes a 1/4-inch nut driver. Put it in there, twist it. And you don't want to take it all the way out, but you give it a few turns and that loosens it. And when I take it apart, you'll see what's inside. There's something in there that's like a little lever that flips to hold the bearing in place. So by loosening that, we're allowing this back piece to move free. But before we can actually take the motor apart, we have to remove these long bolts that run through the motor and pull the two halves together. So sometimes these are a little bit hard to get off. Now you may need to use like a 5/16 wrench or a ratchet and break them free. Sometimes they come off really easily. It depends on your motor, what condition it's in, how rusted things are inside. So I'm gonna at least loosen them up at first. And be careful not to break them. Now, so that one's loose. Again, I try to do one side and then the other side. And once you get them loose, you can use a nut driver and spin them free. So they're pretty loose now, so I'm gonna grab my 5/16 nut driver and take them out of there. Okay, pull all four of them out. Now, the other thing I probably should have told you to do before this, but we can still do it now, is before you take it apart, you want to mark the case to the outer pieces to the center piece so that we put it back together, you put it back together the same way. Sometimes it's hard to line things up. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this pen and I'm gonna put a couple lines on here just to mark where things came apart. So put a little line there. And Maybe I'll put two of them over here just in case those come off. And on the other side, well, look at this. This has already been marked before. If you look right here, probably from when I took this pump apart or this motor apart in the past. Now, I'll put another line over here too. The next step is to remove the two halves. And I'm not sure which one I should remove first, but let's remove this end over here first. Now, this end will have the, if I remember correctly, it'll have the bearing right here near the end with a little spring washer in it. So what I recommend doing is just tap it lightly. Don't pound on it. Of course, you never really want to pound anything with a hammer. But tap it lightly, and as you see, the case is coming apart. The other thing that you could do is sometimes you can get a screwdriver in here and kind of pry it apart a little bit. Just try not to damage anything as you're taking it apart. Okay, so that came apart pretty easily. This pulls out, and you'll look, and you'll see one of the bearings right here. So that's one of the bearings we're going to replace. Now, the other thing to see, like I mentioned, there's this little springy washer. Make sure you don't forget to put that back in. That goes here in the end of the motor. And we're going to pull this bearing out. But before we can do that, we have to take off the other back end of the motor. Because we want to pull out the whole inside guts. I think it's called the stator, but I could be wrong. So same thing with the back end. I think if we tap this, it will pull apart. And actually, even if we left this on, the whole inside guts of this thing would come out together. So it's actually all coming out together, so we'll just pull the whole thing out as one piece. Now you can see here, maybe you can see it, maybe you can't, but inside you can see the screw that we loosened earlier. It's pushing this little, I don't know what you call this piece in here, but this little lever that holds that bearing in place. And once you free it, this back half of the shaft should slide off of here. There it goes. It's like magic. It comes apart. So now you can set this piece aside, and actually this gives you a better idea of that little lever piece that I was talking about. When you turn the screw, when you tighten it, this flips over this direction, and this piece here holds the bearing in place. When you unscrew it and loosen it, this piece flips over and allows the bearing to slide out on the shaft. And you can see there's a little bit of grease in here. We put it back together, we're going to put some grease. Because my understanding is as the motor gets hotter or colder, metal contracts and expands, and it allows things to move around a little bit. The bearing itself shouldn't be spinning inside of here, but you want to allow it to be able to move in and out slightly as it's heating up and cooling down. So the next step we're going to do is remove these bearings. This is probably the most difficult part, but it's also not really that difficult. So wipe this off, get it kind of clean. Now, be really careful with this piece. This is a balanced piece of metal. You don't want to drop it on the floor because you're going to damage your motor. It's pretty much worthless. You don't want to crush it into the vise and bend it. That'll throw things out of balance. So be pretty careful with it. Now, what I do, I'm going to take it over here to the vise. I'm going to throw it inside a towel like this. And I guess I'll pull off the top bearing first. Stick it into the vise. And I'm not going to crank down on this and make it tight or anything. I just want it to hold it in place while I pull off this bearing. And this bearing, you can't just pull it off by hand. We've got to use one of these bearing pullers. But it should come off pretty easily. And the same thing with the bottom one. We're going to pull it the other direction. So I have this nice, cheap bearing puller that I bought at Harbor Freight. I think it cost me $20 for a set of three different pieces of bearing pullers. They are very cheap. This is not a high quality tool. I just needed it for simple jobs like this. Stick it on there, get the jaws around the outside of it, tighten it up a little bit, kind of tight. And then I think this is a 17 millimeter wrench. Yep, put your wrench around the top. And what I do is I squeeze these jaws together and I turn the wrench. And what it's causing it to do is it's pulling this bearing up as this pushes down. And after 5 or 6 turns, this thing should pop off. You see it sliding up very slowly there. If you were going to reuse this bearing, you'd probably want to be careful to make sure the jaws were only touching the center metal surface of the bearing, the inner race of the bearing. I don't really care. I'm going to throw these away, so if I damaged it, so what? So the first one is removed. We're going to flip it over and do a similar thing to the other side to remove this other bearing. Wrap my towel around it somewhat. Find a good way to mount it in here so that I don't damage it. I'll set it up here like this. And like that. And for this one, I'm going to use the smaller tool. This, since it has the slot in it, the end of my bearing puller has a flat surface on it. So that it doesn't, you know, poke into that or damage the end of the shaft in any way. Not sure it matters that much. Put it down on there, on the bearing, similar to like we did with the other one. Squeeze it together. And we're gonna use a 14 millimeter wrench for this one. Now, your tool may be different. And the same as before, you just turn this, and this bearing should slide right off the end of the shaft. You see it moving upward. And then you'll feel when it comes loose, take your bearing off, toss it in the trash. So now we're gonna put the new bearings on the shaft. For that, there's probably lots of fancy tools out there. I don't own them. But what I do have is my fancy tools, which are a 3/4 inch piece of PVC pipe and a bigger one and a smaller one. And somewhere here I have the new bearings. Here they are. So the bearings for this motor and pump, I bought these on Amazon. I think they were, you know, $5 or $6 for a set of two. 6203-2RS. Bearings out of the package. Nice new shiny bearings. These come pre-lubed. You can look, make sure they're the same size, make sure they're the same width. Now, and we're gonna put them on the shaft. So to put them on the shaft, set the bearing on the end of the shaft, and it has to slide all the way down to that end. And the way I'm gonna do this is I'm gonna grab my special tool, which was the PVC pipe that's sitting around here somewhere. Oh, here it is in front of me. And the PVC pipe, if you look at this, it's going to come in contact with the center or the inner race of the bearing and not contact the other surfaces. It's going to push that down onto the metal shaft and put that on there, center it. It's flush. It's all the way down on there. Spins freely. Grab the other new bearing. And we're going to do the same thing on this end. Put it on the shaft. hold this here. And for this one, I think I have the smaller piece of pipe, which is right here. And also you want to make sure that you hit it with something that's relatively flat. Now, and also here, we're going to tap it on. Making sure that it goes down straight. Okay, that's on there. I think when I was first hitting it, it probably wasn't going totally flat, totally straight down, but you can see the bearing is completely on there now. It's bottomed all the way out, and you can tell when you're tapping it by the sound that you hear when you've reached the bottom. So it's on there. Everything spins pretty freely. Other end spins freely. So we're done replacing the bearings. We're going to put this back together. Now, next step I'm going to do is mount the tail housing on the end of this. And the first thing I'm going to do is put a little bit of grease in here so that it slides in smoothly. And this is the little lever here that will, when the bearing's in place, this will close when you tighten on the screw and hold it in place to keep it from falling out. So I'm going to put that in first. Now, and the bearing should just slide in that hole with very little force, or minimal force, I guess I should say. So I'm going to kind of tap it on here. It's in there. Next thing I'm going to do is take this screw and my nut driver here and tighten it to hold that bearing in place. Okay, now that's in place. The screw's tightened. Everything, you can see everything spins freely, which is good. Now we're going to slide this through the motor, put it in there, and I'll put this little rubber gasket over here, piece before I forget it on the end. Now what we want to do is on the other end, slide this piece, making sure to leave the little springy washer in here, and the other end of the motor on. And at the same time, line up the marks that we put on here before when we took it apart. Okay, and that one's lined up there. You can take the hammer and just tap it gently. Place, and you see on the top here the little line that I put on there before has lined up, and then on the other end, I'll try to line up the marks that we posted over or put over here. There's one there, this line's up there. We'll tap this little mark. So those line up, the three marks over here line up. Now, put our screws back in here. Now these are really rusty. You might want to put a little WD-40 or oil on the end of them, grease, just to make it easier to take it apart next time. the three bolts in place. And then these are your 5/16 nut driver again. Tighten them gently, pull it together. And after I put this together, one of the things I want to do is just run the motor for a few seconds to make sure that it works all right. You don't have to do that, but I want to feel good that I didn't break anything when I took it apart, put it back together. So I'm going to hook up some power. I have here a 220 volt outlet in the garage and run some power over to the end of this motor and give it a spin. Okay, everything is together. I don't think you really need to crank down these. You could maybe give them a little bit more of a turn here, but these are very tiny bolts. You don't want to break them. That would be really bad. Okay, motor's all together. What I'm going to do is I'm going to hook up the power to the ends of this here. I can set it up here and do this. Now, get my handy little extension cord tool. Okay, I'm going to hook up some power to this thing and just give it a spin and make sure everything works all right. Now I'm going to plug it into the wall here and just give it a test and make sure things spin correctly. Sounds nice and quiet, nice and smooth, not vibrating. All is good inside of the motor. That's a good sign. So the next step is we're gonna drop the motor into the housing here. Kind of a reverse order that we took it apart. Push this through here. Orient it like that. And first put our big bolts in here. Get the four of them in. First, I just get them snug, and then I will crank down on them a little bit tighter once I get them all in there nice and snug. And anything else, you probably don't want them over tighten. Next step is to put the impeller back in. It's got the new seals in it now. Slide that in. This, holding on to the end of the motor itself and spin it on. You can use a half inch wrench again to give it a good tug at the end. Make sure it's on there nice and tight. Okay, it's on there. Okay, you've already lubed up your new seal there. And the final step is to put on the, or almost the final step, is to put on the volute. Make sure all the holes line up. First, slide it on a little bit. Get it on there. Get all the bolts in by hand. With hand tight. And six bolts that go on here. 1/2 inch wrench. And I like to kind of also tighten these back down using the star pattern. Side. And the thing is, you want to make sure that when you tighten it down so that it goes down evenly. Once you have all of them, you think they're all kind of snug, you want to go around and just check all of them one at a time, make sure that they're all on there good and tight. But not too tight, you don't want to be breaking anything. Don't ask me what the torque spec is because I don't know. But there's probably one there somewhere. Okay, now a couple final things to do. Put this back on the end of the pump. And then there's also a gasket that goes right on here, a little rubber seal that you should change. And you know, I have one laying around here somewhere. This little guy here. This wasn't leaking, probably doesn't need to be changed, but for completeness, I will run over here. It's a little bit of the O-ring and back onto the end of this. And then screw the drain plug back in here with the new seal on it, since I had it. There you have it, a brand new, totally rebuilt Polaris P460 pump. Thank you.